Kenya, East Africa, a place of incredible splendor. Known for its wildlife and the Great Rift Valley, few places on earth compare to its beauty. Kenya also has earned a reputation of political progress and peace among tribes. But in 2008, that peace was challenged. In December of 2007, Kenya held its presidential elections. The results were questioned, which led to riots and protests. As the new year arrived, the protests escalated into unprecedented violence, leading to over 1,000 deaths and the displacement of over 350,000 people. Kenya became engulfed in tribal hostility that ripped to the heart of the nation.
Five years ago, when God was calling Debbie and I to Africa, one of the words He gave us was to connect resources and ministry of the American church to the needs and challenges of the African church. That directive took on a whole new meaning because of the violence that took place in Kenya in 2008. Everything about this nation changed at the beginning of this year, and Mission Barnabas was in a unique position to be able to offer resources and connect ministers from the United States to help heal the deep hurt that the nation suffered. Be prepared to be moved as you see some of what you helped us do to bring God's love to a broken nation. We discovered 46 displaced families who were living in a makeshift refuge. We helped them reestablish their lives by finding homes and providing capital to start new businesses. We organized a five-day soccer tournament in one of the worst-hit areas of Nairobi, where 52 teams competed. And over 25,000 people from the community turned out to hear Christ being shared. I was then introduced to three young men who they had previously embraced Islam, but after the tournament, gave their hearts to Jesus. We aided at two schools who were in desperate need of help. The first was a school in an area that had been torn apart by the violence, that they were in dire need of just the basic supplies, pencils and rulers and notebooks. A school teacher in Texas had collected new school supplies and boxed them up, and she'd ask if we could put them in the container, and when we got to Kenya, find a place that needed them. We found Lighthouse Academy. At the second school, we were able to give three new computers to be used for education. We even went back a few months later and we were overwhelmed with how the students were advancing. You should have seen the smiles on their faces. We also loved on orphans. We ministered to deaf college students. We gave out shoes at a shelter for homeless boys. The violence that Kenya suffered had far-reaching impact, and the local church was not immune to the hurt. The central vision of Mission Barnabas is to touch the leader of the African church, and 2008 gave us a great opportunity to bring healing, forgiveness, restoration to the church by ministering to the leaders. During our March leadership conference, we were able to minister to pastors about forgiveness and unity, and we saw years of tribal hate washed away as leaders forgave and embraced each other. We had so many leaders that we were not sure where we'd put them all. They came and said, "We're willing to sleep anywhere." They begged us not to turn them away. We just finished building and roughing out the new rooms in the new building. In fact, the walls were not finished yet. The floors were still very rough. But we decided to put down some plywood and then put little mattresses on the floors. The pastors loved it. They were so gracious, even with such poor accommodations. Okay, now I'm standing inside of one of the rooms. We have this room here and then one next to it. We put mattresses down, and you can see here the size of the mattress that they're sleeping on. We were going to sort of spread it out where everybody would have plenty of room. We had so many come, we just pushed mattresses together, and some we have three people on two mattresses. You can see sort of what it's like. This room, probably both of these rooms, I think we figured we could put maybe 50 pastors. I think we have about 80 or 85 pastors here. And I wonder how all these pastors are doing. Because of, I know it's more crowded in here than when we would like, and you have been so wonderful about it. And you don't have showers here. You have to go over there to use showers. So we want to bless you. We're going to give you a brand new copy. This is a Bible dictionary that we're going to give each one of you a copy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In June, we had our largest conference to date with more than 750 pastors and leaders. Every inch of our facility was put to use. We taught on building leadership teams, and we equipped them with concordances and study Bibles and books of all kinds. In 2008, we hosted 10 regional meetings all over the nation, ministering to more than 4,000 leaders. And now it's hard to believe that it's been 5 years, but I want you to join me in celebration as we look at all that God has done through Mission Barnabas during our 5 years in Kenya. We have hosted 13 conferences for more than 6,000 delegates. We planned and led 46 regional meetings in 3 different countries for over 25,000 delegates. We've shipped 6 sea containers, and in them over 38,000 Bibles and books and concordances, thousands of tapes and CDs, tens of thousands of pages of study notes, over 100 computers, generators, sound equipment, musical equipment, all that for the center, and much, much more. We funded and built also a 500-seat pavilion, as well as 3 new classrooms in the new building. And all of this has been possible because you gave. In 2009, we're asking you to give again. We have 4 conferences scheduled and more than 10 regional meetings planned. And we're planning to fund and build a dining hall and kitchen so that we'll no longer have to eat under a tent. We are also looking to add more sleeping space to the new building so that we can host even more leaders. We look forward to another great year of giving your resources away to the church in Africa. We look forward to touching another leader and seeing him spread the fire to his church in town. We look forward to God continuing his work of healing of the nation of Kenya through Mission Barnabas. So thank you for your sacrifice, and may God richly bless you, and may God bless America.